Hey guys, and welcome to my latest video on modding Mass Effect 3. Today what we'll be doing is giving Mass Effect 3 custom and high resolution textures for single player and multiplayer. So this is a two-part video, and the first part is showing you the mods in action, so I can show you before and after shots of certain parts of the game, the enemies and such, and show you the improvements that you get with the high resolution textures. And the second part is showing you how to do it yourself. So if you just want to skip to that part, skip to 7 minutes 50 now, and then I'll see you later. For those of you who are still here, let's have a look at some of these textures in action. So this is the cannibals, and the first thing I want you to notice is, this is the low resolution version, is look at its gun on its hand, and some of the face textures, especially the second face on its right shoulder. Now, look at the high res version. And the first thing you'll notice is the much higher pixel density. And that's the low resolution version as a comparison. So I just think this is such a massive improvement that it's completely worth the hassle for me. And there isn't much hassle, so don't worry about that for the moment. But just have a look at this particular model here, and I just think it looks great. Like, you can see so much detail, especially on the second face, that I didn't even notice until making this video. Here's another version with Tali here, and this is the low resolution version, which in a second it'll change to the high res, and here we go. So the first thing that I would say is that the swirls on her shawl, let's call it, are far greater resolution, so there's no longer any blurring in the lines, like this version here, that's way blurred, and it becomes very noticeable the closer you zoom into the character. But when you switch over to the high res, there's no longer any blur between the lines. And also her suit is done far greater, and there's also some detail inside her mask, which the modder has added, which I quite like as well. If you can't see the differences between these two versions, then definitely watch the video in 1080p, because I've tried to upload it in as high a quality as I could, so that you could tell the difference. Here's the standard Avenger. And you can also use custom textures to make it different colors and such. So this is a white Avenger that's also higher resolution than the original. Even zoomed in quite close, you can still see the greater texture detail. You can also use these mods in multiplayer. So this is a high resolution Fury with the black missile launcher on her back, and also I've also modded the cannibals as well for this particular video. So you can see, even in multiplayer, still high resolution. And the same thing works with other weapons as well. So this is a Revenant that's white. Here's a Predator, which is in very high resolution. So look how close you can zoom in and still get quite a lot of quality, especially compared to Shepard's hand. There are other things you can mod too, like the starting menu. This is my new starting menu, and I think it looks better than the original, frankly. This is actually in low resolution, and when we change it over to high resolution, there's far greater detail on her armor. I think this looks absolutely fantastic. You can just keep zooming in and zooming in, and you just see so much more detail, especially on the helmet and her shoulder blades especially. Like, you can see every individual dot on the armor. And there's also some nice touches there with like cuts and scrapes on the armor. You can also do it to other NPCs like the Quarian Admirals. That's a high resolution version. And also onto objects in the worlds. So this is just a high resolution version of the door. And as you saw, you can zoom right in. This is a comparison between two shots of the exterior of the Normandy with the high resolution second. And if it freezes there, that's a high res version. And switch over to the low res. And I think there's such a dramatic improvement there, it just looks fantastic. There's also some mods for the interior of the Normandy. So this is low res, and have a look at that. And then we can switch it over to high res, and you notice the walls are like a sort of brushed stainless steel, which looks great. And you can zoom in here onto the elevator, and just look how much detail there is. You can zoom right in and still read the text on the elevator. And same thing with some of the terminals. But not only can you change things to make them look higher resolution, you can also change them to look slightly differently depending on what you want to see. So for instance, Edie here has got a mod on which gives her sort of hexagonal textures on her skin, as well as those well, skin, quotation marks, and also those sort of arc reactor like shoulder blades and stuff. Here's another shot of a high resolution husk here, and some more enemies like the guardians and the assault troopers. As you can see, there's, if you zoom right in, you can see all the individual scratches on the armor. And here's a final shot of some really great looking N7 armor. This is the default armor, and look how much detail there is. You can zoom right in, see scratches on the armor, see all the individual bumps and lines, which I think is just fantastic. And if we finally go off here, here's some before and after shots of Liara in her default armor. And as you can see, it's kind of difficult to tell the resolution difference from this shot because it's not the closest, but I just love the look of it. It just looks so fantastic, in my opinion. And yeah, just look at that. So we're coming up onto the instruction part of the video, and there's a few things I want to say before we get into that. The main thing that you're going to be concerned about when you're adding lots of mods is that you need to make sure that your RAM on your computer and also your VRAM can take it, because every single texture you load is added to the RAM and the VRAM, so you need to have enough RAM to run it. So for instance, on my machine, when I was loading up about like 40 or 50 or so mods, then when I had the game running, it took about 2.5 gig of system RAM, and I have no idea how much VRAM it was using. So if you haven't got enough RAM there, then I don't know what happens, but it'll probably start like not loading some of the textures. The other issue is with loading times, because when you start up Mass Effect 3 with the texture modding program, it will take some time to load every single one of the textures. So depending on how many textures you have, it may take quite some time to load. So when I was using it for that many mods, you know, like 40, 50, it could take something like 8 minutes to start up the game. And that's obviously like overkill. You know, you don't need 50 mods every time you run the game. So I'd recommend that if you're going to do this all the time, work out which mods you actually want to run every time you want to run the program. So if you're just running on multiplayer, there's no need to go for stuff like Shepard's armor or armor for special NPCs like Ashley or your squad mates and stuff. So only load the ones that you need to minimize your loading time and the load on your RAM and the system. So this is the main page that you're going to be going to find all the different texture mods for Mass Effect 3. It's a thread on the BioWare social network, as you can see here, and this will all be linked in the description so that you can easily find it. Whenever you want to download a different texture mod, just come to this page and there's lots of links here for all the different ones that you'll ever need. And they keep getting updated as well. So all of these different pictures, they're different texture mods basically. And so you got them for characters, weapons, areas, enemies, all sorts of stuff. Everything you've seen in the video prior has come from basically this page. So the first thing you want to do is download this program called TexMod, which is linked here, and it's also linked in the description as a direct link. So if you just click it in the description and you go straight to this page here, download this, and then you get something like this TexMod. And if you open it up in a second, it'll just look like this. So that's what you're going to end up with. But first of all, you'll need some texture mods to run. And so you can just come to this page and pick any particular thing you want. So here we got Liara. Click on the link and then simply download whichever one you want. And then it's wise to place it in the same directory as TexMod so that it's easy to find. So I put in here and then characters, Liara. So that's easy enough. And so whenever you want something, come straight to this page. This is the best place to go. And it keeps getting updated all the time, so stay tuned for more stuff. So once you've got your text mod program and some texture mods to run with, the next step is to launch the program. And unfortunately, it's not as easy as just launching it normally, because you need to open Mass Effect 3 through the text mod program, and that can lead to some clashes with Origin. So the easiest workaround that I've found is when you use a batch launcher. And for some of you, you might have seen one of my earlier videos where I showed you how to make a customized launcher program. And so what I've just done is added on a little bit onto that original one to make it work with this text mod program. So the text on the right is the easiest way to get past the origin problem with text mod and launching the program. So this text will be in the video description, and I'll just show you quickly, if you don't already know, how to make this into a batch program like I've done. So just open up Notepad, which you can do by going to the Start menu and Accessories. Then copy all of this, chuck it into your Notepad, and then save it as a .bat file. So you can call it whatever you want for the file name, but the file type has to be .bat. That is the only file type that'll make it into a program, so make sure you do that, otherwise it will not work. So then save that into some location, and then you can double click it and open this little box here, and this is the program. So what it says is run Mass Effect 3 with text mod ? So before this stage, what you'll have to have done is gone to your Mass Effect 3 installation directory, binaries, Win32, and placed a copy of text mod inside of this folder. If you're good enough with batch files, then you don't have to do that, and you can manually change the file yourself, but this is the easiest way. So just copy and paste your text mod file into here, and then make a backup copy of your Mass Effect 3 executable. This is very important, because if you don't have a backup when you're modding things, if something goes wrong, you're screwed. So make a backup copy. I haven't had to use it, so it's probably superfluous, but it's a good idea to have it. And one thing I should quickly mention is that when you're making your batch file, just make sure that the path is correct, so the folders are named correctly. So this is what it's supposed to be named on my computer, but it could be slightly different on yours. So just work out exactly what you need to put there, and then update it yourself. Alrighty, so our batch program. Type yes, or Y, enter, and it says, files renamed, please start now your Mass Effect 3 in Origin. So what we can see here is it's renamed the text mod to MassEffect3.exe, and it's changed the Mass Effect 3 executable to a temp. And then what we do is we open up Origin, then we say play, and it says launching Mass Effect 3, but instead of launching Mass Effect 3, it launches text mod. And that is the trick to getting around Origin, because Origin doesn't like it when you're opening Mass Effect 3 from a separate program. So it tricks, what it's doing is tricking Origin into thinking you're launching it through there, and then you don't. So what we do is we go back to our batch, press any key, and there we have it. That's done. And then what we can see here is it's renamed all of the files back to their original names. So it's put it back to what it was before. Then we go into text mod here, click on MassEffect3.exe, and that's our target application, what we want text mod to open. Then we simply click on browse and find the textures that you want to load into the game. So for instance, I'll click here, Cobra Missile Launcher. And what this will do is it will replace the standard Cobra Missile Launcher in multiplayer and single player with a version which is high resolution, and also it's a black color. So it's got some custom skin on it as well. And then you simply click run. And at that point, depending on how many packages you've got running, so you can also click on more of them, or you can select a whole bunch of them. Depending on how many you've got running, will depend on how long it takes, will determine how long it takes to start up Mass Effect 3. So if you're like me and you've got quite a few of them, then it could take upwards of 5, 6, 7 minutes to load. And for everyone, that's not going to be the best solution. So you really should determine which ones you really want to load at what particular time. So for instance, if you're running multiplayer, you could go with, you know, high-res versions of the players, high-res versions of the enemies, high-res versions of the weapons, but you won't need stuff like characters, so you won't need chains here, you won't need armor, which is just for single player. So take care of which ones you need to load at what particular time. And that'll really cut down on your RAM usage, it'll really cut down on your loading times, and that's just a good tip in general. So yeah, just click run, and that's done. That's how you do it. For those of you who are interested, my version of the launcher is a bit different, so it's quite a bit more complicated, as you can see, but it gives me a lot more options. So if I do this, what I've actually done is I've daisy-chained two processes together such that it'll mod the game with the Coalesced modding at the same time as it launches this texture program. So if I just give it a go here, it'll open up Origin, do that, and then from then on it's just the same thing. So yeah, you can, if you really want to do it that way, then you can do it that way if you want. If you're good enough with batch programs, that is, then you can have a go at it. So yeah, have fun with this program. It really is a big improvement on some of the textures in the game. Some of them are just really low resolution as standard, like the cannibals especially, man. And don't forget to check the forum page, because they update it all the time, and really those guys are really great at this. I have no idea how they do it, but props to them. It works great and it looks fantastic. So thanks for watching, guys. This video has been a long time to make, so I hope you enjoyed it. And yeah, check out some of my previous stuff and consider subscribing. Thanks, guys.